My name is Jack Storms. I'm a cold glass sculptor in Los Angeles, California. I've always been good at art. From when I was a little kid, I always loved to draw and sculpt and create. What made me want to become an artist is I was always good at it, and I fell in love with the process. So when I got my degree from college, I threw up my hat, and before I caught it, I was having panic attacks about what I was going to do with this degree in art. But I always knew that if you take art seriously, you can find a career in it. What makes the artwork so unique is the fact that there are very few people on the planet that undertake this endeavor to create this type of artwork. Basically, 99.9% of the art glass that you see out there in the world is formed hot. That is to say, they get their materials and they start manipulating the shape of the glass and start playing around with the colors, and they do that hot. So they administer flame to it, or they put it in a kiln, or, you know, there's several methods. But what I do is I don't use any heat at all. I grind and grind and grind, and then I polish, and that's what separates me from everybody else. It's much more difficult and it takes a lot more time, but for me, the effects are just brilliant. Each one of these pieces takes approximately 8 to 18 weeks to complete from start to finish. Because of the labor involved and because of the perfection, because of the tolerances being so tight, it's a pursuit of perfection at every single turn. So because of that, they take some time. One of the things about my work that I find so exciting is that I incorporate a Fibonacci sequence and Fibonacci ratios into the work. The Fibonacci ratio is the golden ratio. It's everywhere in nature. It's why a tree grows so tall versus so wide. It's everywhere in our body. Its ratios are in our face. Your nose is in a ratio to your eye, and you see it almost universally in a conch shell. That spiral comes out. That's a ratio. The reason why I use that in my artwork is because all good artwork has it, but it's crucial to my work because I rely on a straight line. All of my polishing surfaces have to be straight, and there's no such thing as a straight line in nature. So what I've got to do is take these straight lines that don't occur in nature and make them natural. So I've got to use that Fibonacci as a bridge between the collector and the artwork, because without it, it looks very manufactured and it looks very automated, and it's not. It's labor intensive. At every step of the process is intense human interaction in its pursuit of perfection. So to get that across, to get it across that it's a creation and not something that's being manufactured, then the Fibonacci is absolutely crucial. I draw inspiration from being able to pull ideas out of the ether, being able to touch the creative, being able to draw from that creative wellspring, being able to take something from your head, your thoughts, and being able to translate them into something that's solid right in front of you. A lot of people ask me what my artwork means to me. What does this piece mean to me? But that's not the right question. My question is, what is this artwork going to mean to the person that's going to take it home? Because that's what, to me, this artwork is really all about. What does it mean to the person that is going to put this in their home and look at it every day? That's where I get my meaning from. So when someone says, Jack, what does the artwork mean to you? I turn it around on them and I say, you've got to tell me what it means to you. Is this something that you bought for your wife for an anniversary gift? Or is this something to remember your trip to Hawaii? Or is it something that you just want to buy to look at every day because it's just so beautiful? Because if that's the answer, because it looks so beautiful, then the answer is I created it out of sheer beauty.